And another angel, the third one, followed them, saying in a loud voice, If anyone worships the beast and its image, and receives a mark on his forehead or on his hand, he also will drink the wine of God's wrath, poured unmixed into the cup of his anger, and he will be tormented with fire and sulfur, in the presence of the holy angels, and in the presence of the Lamb. If anyone, it says, bows down to the beastly Antichrist, and pursues the ungodly lifestyle modeling him, and either in word or in deed, proclaims him God, for this can be clear by the mark given on the forehead and hand, he also will partake with him of the drink of the cup of vengeance, on the one hand unmixed, and separated from the divine mercies, because of the righteous judgment, on the other hand, having been poured with various punishments on account of the multiplicity and variety of its self-chosen wickedness. And the smoke of their torment goes up forever and ever. This smoke must imply either the labored breath that comes out along with the groaning of those being punished emanating up from below, or the smoke coming forth from the fire, punishing those who have fallen. It is to go up forever and ever, it says, that we might learn that it is endless, just as the bliss of the righteous, and in like manner also the torment of the sinners. The false signs which are operated through the demons, it says, will cause those persuaded by them to march into war on the great and terrible day of God, judge of the living and the dead, over which, having been entirely defeated, those fighting against God in vain will lament, bewailing their prior error. 16. And he assembled them at the place which is called in Hebrew Armageddon. The watchfulness and guarding the garments mean vigilance and good deeds. For these are the garments of the saints, of which he who is deprived will need to be ashamed, since he is naked and full of indecency. Armageddon is interpreted as deep cut, or that which is cut in two. He has referred to those campaigning with the devil in the plural, because of the many diverse and multifaceted forms sin. However, there are few compared to the angelic powers and the humans who are equal to the angels, for those following Christ are expressed by the singular army, because of the united will and unity of opinion about pleasing God, the Logos. And the beast was captured, and with it the false prophet who in his presence had worked the signs by which he deceived those who had received the mark of the beast, and those who worshipped its image. Although they, together with those kings and rulers who were obedient to them, marched against the Savior Christ. Nonetheless, both of them were defeated, the Antichrist and the false prophet who had performed signs and wonders, the well-received deceptions, were overtaken by the divine wrath. These two will be thrown alive into the lake of fire that burns with sulfur. Perhaps these will not die a common death, but in the twinkling of an eye those made immortal are condemned to a second death in the lake of fire, as the apostle says concerning other people. They will not sleep, but they will be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye. These likely will go to judgment, but those two who presented themselves as impious and anti-gods, not into judgment but directly to condemnation,